our country is very divided along these lines. And you know, I don't think with any outcome that that is going to go away anytime soon. And I mean, that's a it's an uncomfortable thing for us to experience, because I don't think many people on either side of the debate appreciate.
The agony.
No, I don't think it will.
Well, tell me how it won't then.
Well, look, I happen to think having a people's vote, which can be done within a small number of months, to be able to resolve whether that Brexit deal is what people want or whether they want to remain. And if we chose to remain, you know, we would at least be able to get on with focusing on the other issues that currently get almost no attention from the government, because all of the political oxygen is consumed by Brexit. But I'm not looking at this through rose-tinted spectacles. You know, I recognise...
Well, no, you're not, because you haven't explained how it's going to calm the country down.
I would at least bring a resolution to the issue.
Because, well, so would leaving.
No.
Oh,
well,
no. I see. So remaining would bring a resolution. Why wouldn't leaving bring a resolution, Jo Swinson?
At least if we're remaining on the current terms, then politics can move on. I'm not suggesting
that
people...
if Britain were to leave on October
31st... But if we were to leave, that is the beginning. That is the beginning of years and years of negotiations and wrangling, because all of those issues that have still to be determined would have to be discussed.
Right.
So anyone that thinks that if we leave on the 31st of October or whenever, that that's Brexit done and dusted, that's just the beginning of years and years and years of chaos.
And just lastly, you're the leader of the Liberal Democrats Party. Just again, explain to my listeners, what's democratic about ignoring the result of the referendum?
I'm arguing for a democratic exercise for
people. But what was 3 years ago then?
Well, it was a democratic exercise, but not.
So we have another democratic exercise. How many democratic exercises are we going to do? What's exercise
every
year?
Well, you can let me answer the question, Nick, or you can just
talk. I don't see why
you
don't respect democracy, but do go ahead. You want to explain?
Yeah. So it was a democratic exercise, but not on a specific prescription of what Brexit would look like. We had this meaningless phrase, Brexit means Brexit, and it was a blank canvas to which people, you know, projected whatever they wanted it to look like.
Respectfully, Brexit means Brexit was post-referendum.
It was,
Theresa May's interpretation.
It was, but still pretty meaningless.
I'm asking you about 3 years ago.
And you know, literally nobody at that point was talking about, for example, crashing out without a deal. We had all of the Brexiteers lining up to say we were going to get a great deal, it was going to be the easiest deal in human history. You know, that is what we were being told. That is very different to what is on offer now from Boris Johnson, set to become Prime Minister, who's saying we might crash out without a deal on the 31st of October, with all that will mean for our NHS, for all that will mean for our food supplies, for all that will mean for the chaos to our economy. So, yeah, what is on offer now is markedly different to 3 years ago. So a democratic exercise, yes, on starting negotiations. What I'm arguing for is a democratic vote on what Brexit actually looks like, to confirm whether that is the path people want to go down.